Hi there, I'm Carly Fairbrother. I'm the last grown up in the woods. And today I'm going to be talking about berries, because who doesn't like to eat berries? I'm going to be talking about three general types of berries, so three genuses. That means there's multiple types of berries in each genus. They grow pretty much everywhere, or at least grow in most temperate areas. So let's go over some of the things that can help you identify the first of my three general types of berries, the Rubus genus. There are actually six species of Rubus growing wild around here. Two of them are invasive, the evergreen blackberry and the Himalayan blackberry, with one native blackberry, thimbleberry, salmonberry, and black raspberry. So here we have the elusive black raspberry. Not that it's actually elusive, there's actually tons of it growing around here. And not that it's actually a berry either. It's actually technically an aggregate of drupulates. The black raspberry is a great example of a typical Rubus species. The actual shape of it looks a lot like a raspberry. The reason I know that this is a black raspberry and not a blackberry is that if I were to pick it and put it on my finger like this, it would make a little finger hat. With blackberries, you can't do that. That's why it's a good reason for most Rubus species to always check the insides for bugs before you eat them. The leaves generally form in leaflets of 3 to 5. This one forms in 3, but up here, same plant, it's actually formed leaflets of 5. They often have prickles. They sometimes don't. This one is a thimbleberry. It's a little bit more atypical than the black raspberry I just showed you. The drupulates are a lot smaller, and the berry has a bit of a fuzzy appearance. The leaves are also fuzzy, which actually makes them really great as toilet paper. But their leaves also look a little bit like another plant that you might know. But if I take these leaves and I tear each one of these leaflets off and kind of put them together like this, you can look at them right next to each other. They kind of look similar. There are more variations in what the leaves look like. The 5-leaf bramble has much rounder leaves. Now we move on to the blackberry. This one is the Himalayan blackberry. It's introduced. It's actually introduced to many places in the world. These ones grow more in a vine, and they kind of have those nasty, nasty thorns that you are probably familiar with if you've ever gone blackberry picking. I've shown you several shrubs, but species in the Rubus genus can also be quite a bit smaller, like this cloudberry. Their flowers look a little like this. They can be white or purple or pink. The second berry I want to talk about is, I'm pretty much not going to talk about it. It's a strawberry, and there's many species of strawberry. You probably know the one that grows in your garden. Most wild ones are a lot smaller. Most wild ones are a lot more flavorful. They are also, interestingly enough, not technically berries. They are fruit with little seeds on the outside. I don't know what their technical definition would be. And here's an image of the wild strawberry that grows around here, and the flower as well. Yeah. Guess what? I had an allergic reaction to a hornet sting, so I'm icing it with these cranberries. Which brings me to the third berry that I want to talk about, the one that includes blueberries and huckleberries and cranberries. Vaccinium is probably the most widely spread genus that I'm talking about today. There are 450 species! They can be anywhere from low-lying brush in alpine meadows to 30-foot trees in Florida. They're also cool because they tend to grow in places that other plants don't really want to. They like acidic soils. The Vaccinium species in Hawaii, which name is there, so I don't have to pronounce it, actually grows in volcanic ash and lava flows. So here's my cranberry. It's frozen, round, obviously. Vacciniums can range from black to blue to red. They all have this similar top, kind of like four tiny leaves folded in on itself. All vacciniums will have those little leaves, often it's more than four. And all of them are edible. They tend to be tart, and they tend to ripen a little bit later. It is blueberry season. I'll cut to a blueberry now. This blueberry shows a lot better example of that typical vaccinium crater at the top. This is on the side, not attached at the end. The little scruffy bits are some of the remains of the flowers. Red huckleberry is very common in the general lower mainland area, but not in Hope for some reason. I've only seen a couple plants. So I'm going to take my camera up into Manning and show some up there, and I'm going to take it into the Skagit and show some there. Here in the Skagit, I have found the red huckleberry. The berries are, for the most part, still green. You can see some that are turning a little bit red. Let's talk a little bit about the stems. You can see here that they're woody, and that's pretty typical for a vaccinium plant. And the leaves are oval. Sometimes they can be a bit more lance-shaped with pointy ends, but these red huckleberry leaves are pretty typical. They have an alternate leaf pattern. That means that one leaf will grow here on the stem and one leaf here. This is opposed to an opposite leaf pattern where they would look a little more like this. Opposite to each other. Their stems can be green like this one. Often the new ones are green, but they can also be reddish or brownish, especially in the older parts of the stems. I'm exploring a subalpine meadow today in Manning Park, so I've seen several species of vaccinium around here. Some of them aren't even flowering yet. It's the end of June, and these berries will typically not ripen until the end of August or September. They're great fall foraging, wonderful for bears, wonderful for people. Do you hear that grouse? No, of course it stops. I am looking at some other types of vacciniums right here. I don't actually know what this one is. It could be dwarf blueberry. I could be wrong, and if I am, there's probably some writing on the screen right now correcting me. You can see that this one is much smaller, much more like a ground cover plant. If you take a look at the flowers, you can see how they're slowly turning into something that looks a little bit more like a huckleberry. Those are the three genuses of berry that probably grow near you if you live in a temperate region of the world. Once again, I want to warn you that although a lot of these berries are very distinctive, you might have lookalikes in your area, so make sure that you take the time to identify the poisonous plants in your area and also the individual species. Don't just go on this, but it can point you in the direction that you might need to go for identifying them. Also, if you put a berry in your mouth and it doesn't taste good, do not eat it. They don't taste good for a reason, and it probably means you've misidentified something.